anyway, the only perfect lawyer I know, also from San Beda, Clase Superior 1905, his name, Justice Gregorio Perfecto. If you will read the book, page 10, he said his first choice for high school was San Beda. But he was prevailed upon, I think, by an uncle to go to high school in Malikina instead. The last time we met was last March 23rd, in recognizing the then Pioneer Hall of Famers in the Fulbright program. He was seated with the ambassador of the U.S. In my table was a honoree, Cora de la Paz. And I linked them together because both of them were active in UNBREL. In fact, during the martial law years, Ed and I had very little to agree on. Although in 1971-72, during the Concon, Avelino Cruz, my townsman from Pasig, invited me to have lunch with Ed in Manila Hotel. And Ed wanted me to be a co-founder of what later became known as ACRA. I said I'd think it over, but I declined. I had by that time founded the San Beda Free Legal Aid Clinic and took a different course. Anyway, my perception of him changed in 1985-86, when along with Cora de la Paz, Numford took a position which like that taken by our colleague, the late Manang Leti Ramasyahani, did not face the dictator. Numbrell was one of the unknown heroes of the 1985-86 struggle. This impressed President Gori and named Ed, as one of their choices to run for the Senate in 1987. The race he won handily, and there he served for many, many years. I should add that Ed Pinizol voted for conviction in 2012. And it's very unkind of some people to say that the vote was because of toxic pork barrels. Anyway, long before his autobiography was launched, we had became fast friends with a deep and abiding respect for each other's, at times differing views on what was best for the motherland. So let me conclude reminding you of what Wordsworth once wrote. What though the radiance that was once so bright be now forever taken from our sight? For nothing can bring back the hour of the splendor in the grass of glory and power. Brave not, rather find the strength in what remains behind. And in the years that bring a philosophic mind. So, Ed, paalam, maraming salamat, enjoy the nation, and wishing you Godspeed for your well-deserved eternal reward.
The Honorable Pia S. Cayetano will now deliver her eulogy.
Where do I begin to tell the story of Senator Cayetano? The stories I have quotes that date back to my childhood, when he and my father were friends and partners in Accra. He was Uncle Ed to me and Edja, without the S for Zedja, without the P for Beja, and spent every summer in the beach house in school. But let me start with a conversation. A conversation we had a few years ago when we were discussing our beloved UK. Both he and I had shared the Covington education. We have both been regents of UP. He would always laugh when I mentioned hearings and meetings that we entered UP together, me as a freshman and he as the UP president. He'd say, Pia, pinapatanda mo naman ako. But then I'd remind him, they were happy days because we, my volleyball teammates and I, won the UAAP championship when he was president. And for that, he gave us 1 year free tuition. All of 400 pesos per semester back then. It has never been repeated. Well, the free tuition, yes, it's now a law. But the championship, no. We remain the UAAP volleyball champions. And then we would both bask in the euphoria of that memory. And he'd say to everyone, para ano ba talaga ang sige. But going back to my story, we were discussing education bills in UP. And I just happened to ask him how he ended up going to UP. He explained to me that a friend told him, well, Victorians will enter UP automatically. And he said, ganun ba? Eh, valedictorian ako. So he made his journey to Manila, found his way to UP, and the rest is history. He graduated from UP Law, and after that, like my father, went to the University of Michigan. It is this provinciano boy from Baler, who would later become UP president, and then a senator, and the Senate president, who passed landmark legislation, bills and education, many of which I had the privilege of working on with him. These laws are the foundation of our education today. And when I asked him just a while back on what else needs to be done, he said, really it's just funding, more funding to make these policies, these dreams a reality. But it wasn't just education. In the area of maternal and infant health, one of the first bills I sponsored when I was new was my expanded breastfeeding app. He approached me when I was defending it and gave me his input. Interestingly, he was the author of the first bill promoting breastfeeding, the Rooming In Act. Later, I took on the fight to protect various national heritage sites, including the Rizal Monument. The basis was his law, the National Heritage Law. Over the years, it no longer surprised me that so many of the legislation I worked on were also his pet bills. He would be so happy that we shared the same interests. Invite me to attend his meetings with experts in the field. I was so excited too, until I realized that he starts his meeting at 7 or 8, and even at 6 a.m. Our common interests went beyond the work in the Senate. He was so thrilled to learn I was studying Spanish. We had very long conversations about our Spanish heritage, his gallantry project, and the need to preserve this same heritage and strengthen our relations with Spain. Another thing that others may not know about him is his support for Philippine grassroots sports, and in particular football. He brought in Real Madrid to train underprivileged Filipino children. I happen to have two daughters who play football for UP. He always asked about them and the UP team. In fact, he has an outstanding offer for them to play in Baler, so I leave this up to Zari. He finished his last term in the Senate over 4 years ago. But I met with him often to chat, to pick his brain, to somehow absorb the wealth of knowledge and experience that he had. In fact, we had planned a summit on English proficiency, which was supposed to happen really soon. I was in China when this happened, and my chief of staff said, "Ano, mga programs natin, malapit na yon." And it's true, I'm sure so many people here today and in the next few days will feel that overwhelming sense of loss, because this great man has left so much behind me. It was clear to me that he had so much going on, from the international projects to local ones in his beloved Baler. To the Para family, Filipino grieve, because we have lost a humble and dedicated citizen. A great team.